Okay, the background's coming together nicely. Okay, now what we're going to start doing is these chipboard pieces I'm thinking are going to be here. Basically, I'm going for a real grunge look card. Okay, so I'm just going to scoot those flowers off and I'm going to do some work. Okay, see why I don't always film all the process because it does get a bit long. I just want to explain it on this. I've just stretched the edges. And there is a start to finish on this. I've torn holes and I put that deco mesh behind. Hopefully that picks up on that mesh. And I've just torn it with a paper trim, and I do have tutorials on this. I've curled back. I've used the Tim Holtz measured stencil, which is like a ruler, and it's on either side. And this is the Tim Holtz die. And I've just gone over black soot and vintage photo and wet it. That's basically it. And it just gives it a discolored look. Okay, now I'm going to do the cheesecloth. Normally, if I was doing spraying, I would dip the cheesecloth in just to absorb that extra stuff so I'm not wasting any extra, but I didn't do that because I didn't have any spraying this time. So what I'm going to do, and I do have a tutorial on the chipboard came out awesome. So basically, I went over with Inca, then I went over with this Stampendous Aged, so it's got like a gold in it and like bronze and different colors. It's good, they're great. So I went in with the blue color, the gold color, and the bronze color, and I did Inca and some brown paint. So that just gave it that different look. And this is DCW's burlap, which I've just gone over with vintage photo on each side, and I've peeled this bit back just to give it a different look on the top bit. And all the flowers you've just seen. Okay, so I'm going to start off with two sprays. I'm going to use the Clambake Beige and the Roll Top Desk. Okay, so what I would normally do is I would just, like I said, absorb it off my mat. But with the cheesecloth, I'm just going to spray. And I'm also thinking of using, I've got some Spanish moss in a bag here, which I'm thinking of using. So it looks kind of overgrown, which I think will look pretty awesome. Just absorb all that. Just want it to look a bit dirty looking. Okay. Hopefully you can pick it up on that, so it's like a greeny yellowy color. And then I'll just go with my brown in spots. With my brown wood spray. Probably because it's not got much in there. And then I'll go in with some vintage photo at the end. Which is right next to me, and just pick up that stuff. Okay, and I'll just quickly heat set that so you guys can see. And this is just medical cheesecloth from the chemist. Great stuff. And it's also going to give it that overgrown look. Just be careful because you can burn it. And the great thing is about the medical cheesecloth, you get heaps. Because that's not it just folded over. Like, it's actually... folded, like tight. I don't know if you guys can see that, but it's all coming. So one piece is that big. So you get heaps. Okay, now I'm just going to go in with my vintage photo. Distressing. I have the big ones, but I've been keeping the little ones near my desk. So I use them. I find I have the Tim Holtings, and I don't use them very often. And, you know... it's a shame because I really love them. You know? I think a lot of the times you forget what you got in your stash when you're working. Okay, And I'm going to go in with, and I keep my little daubers in the back of the ink. And I'm just going to go in with the vintage photo if I can find it. The walnut stain, just a bit, not much of this colour. Just be careful because there's Velcro on the sides. Okay. Done, I think. I think that's perfect. Okay, so I'm going to quickly heat set that and I'll be right back. I'm back. Turned out really nice actually. So I can add that to my pile. And I'm going to grab some of this spray, which I don't have much left. Spray it onto my mat. And I'm going to grab that fan brush that I used in the tutorial. And I'm just going to flick. Because if it's aged, it's usually got some flickage on it. And you can go in with numerous colours. If you go over with your paper towel, that usually will dye down some of the splats and make them lighter and darker. Give it a bit of variance. And we're going to go in with a darker colour. Where's that black soot? Okay, I'm just dabbing it onto my mat. It's very juicy, as you guys can see. I got these at the show. I'm going to add some water to it. And the water just makes it easier to flick. I don't want much black, as you guys can see, on my paper, because it'll just overpower it. Just make it too much. We need a bit there. Sometimes it doesn't dollop in the spots you want it, which is frustrating. Okay, let me put that to the side. And again, I'll do it with this bit. And as you can see, it's just much easier with water. And if it gets to the point where it's really hard to do, add more water. Sloppiness just helps. And you can do this with gesso, gelatos, paint, even. Gelatos work really well. Okay, and hopefully I'm not getting it on my camera lens. Okay. And I'm just gonna wipe that up. Okay. And then next what I'm gonna do is I take my leaves. My grotty hands. And I'm going to take leaves from Wild Orchid again. Rip it over again. What I normally do is these ones are the 50 Green Rose Leaves, the 40mm MKX314. I grab two and I grab three. So five. All up. Okay. And then what I do is I just put two together on one side and make sure it looks nice together because you can see by the curvature and twist them together. Okay. And you can cut a lot of that off if you don't need it and just bend them a bit. You want them poking out over the flower, so the flower will sit like about here. So it gives it that dimension. And I'm just going to add that into the middle. Just excuse my hands. And again, I'm just going to wrap that all up in it. And you could go over that with the vintage photo again. But I'll probably go over gold at the end. Just a bit of gold ink. which I'm going to grab right now. My ink is dried out a bit. You can add wet ones, like wet wipes, to it. But I find that it's the best, other than water. Okay, I still got a brush sitting on the desk, so I'm going to get rid of that. Clean it. You know me, clean freak. Okay, I'm just going to wet it this time because I need it quick. And I'm going to keep a wet one there. And I just kind of run over. It's a bit too wet now. Just kind of run over the edges a bit. So see how they've got the bumps on the leaves? We don't want much. We don't want heaps, but we don't want to be scabby either. And all my flowers. It's better if the stems are on for this. Just easy to grab. There's one in the middle there. So it's just over the edges to give it that shine. Normally I would add more than this, but I'm just wanting, I want to see the brown still. A little bit of gold shining through. I'll just add a bit more on this one because obviously I couldn't go over with Vintage Fetter because it's already dark. Hopefully you guys can see that. So it kind of looks like, I don't know if you've ever seen the Prima flowers, but they have like, some of them have like a gold edge. Just gives them a, I love it. Hopefully you can see that. Okay. And again, and I usually put it on the berries in the middle. And a couple more to go. Doesn't matter if you're random. They put it on. As you can see, I'm not putting it any special way. And then get on those berries. These ones are a bit harder because the berry's in the middle, obviously. So as you can see, gold. Okay, and that's Inca Gold, in the gold colour. I moved it to my desk because I use it on everything, so it's just easier. Okay, so we're nearly ready to be putting it together. Now I'm going to grab that card background again because it should have dried. And I'm just going to grab a stamp. Coming back now, I've grabbed out two stamps. And I've grabbed out these three colours. And I'm just going to do some random stamping. I'm not going to use a block. I like to put them in separate places so I know the packet they came out of because I like to know the numbers and stuff. So, I'm just going to grab this one. And I don't want much of this because it's quite a big stamp. So I'm just going to kind of dab it on in spots. And you can do, as you can see, I just went faint. Didn't even put it on properly. There we are. Perfect. Because I didn't do masking on this, so I really should do some stamping. Where was that backing going? This is Old Road. Now I might go in with a copper colour for the Punchinella type stamp. And again, I'm going to do it on this. There's no right or wrong to this. It's just randomly stamping. And I'm going to go in with that mesh stamp again. In the old... Oops. So that was Rusty Keys. This one's the old road again. And I'm going to grab it. You only need to see parts of it, so really... Don't need it everywhere. Just keep stamping until you can not see it anymore on your stamp. Mixed media is just about playing and having fun with your stuff. What mixed media usually means is using multiple mediums. So you might use texture paste, you might use stamps, you might use embossing. You might use gel medium, you know, sprays. So it's using two or more products. Okay, so I'm going to put them away. That's done. Okay, now it's about time, I think, to put it together. Just want to check it. Okay, I'm just gonna grab some random things from my stash. Metal wise, I don't have many cogs, but I do have pen nibs. I got a pack for like there's like 100 or 200 pen nibs for $7 on eBay, so I grabbed those. I had an old zipper. And then I grabbed some cogs that I had got sent from Murray. So there's those ones. Okay. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to glue that to the burlap. I probably should have got rid of the edge. This is just cheap glue from my $2 store. Clear glue. I prefer clear glue to white glue. It's a preference, I guess. To what you prefer. Gonna glue it on down. Try not to get it where the holes are, and you're gonna see it. Okay, done. I'm gonna glue it down. Make sure I get it the right way. Will help. And in the right place would help. I'm gonna stand up for this. And I'm going to glue it onto the card base. These are the card bases I always use. I get them from my local $2 store. They come with envelopes, which is great. But a lot of people ask how I post my work because it's bulky. I post it in a bigger envelope. So I go for the one size bigger a lot of the times if it's too bulky. And it's not going to fit in the card. There we are, and just grind it up a bit. Okay, and with this, I'm going to use some 3D tape. I don't actually use 3D tape anymore. I just use my scraps of cardboard that I'm sent out of packaging and stuff. Had it. I'm just going to glue it up. Let's just move that down a bit. Good. Okay. That'll just give it a dimensional look in the middle. Get it straight. Okay. There we are. And I've distressed the edges. Okay. There we are. Okay. Now, I'm going to take some Spanish moss. I got this at my local florist. And it's really cheap, actually. I'm going to grab that. And it's really good stuff to use because it will give it that vintage look and that overgrown look that I want with my flowers. And you can use this on cards because it's dried out already. There's no worry to it going mouldy or anything like that. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is I'm going to start adding my embellishments. So first of all, I don't know if I should put how much. So I'm just going to play until I'm happy. But just remember, once your flowers are on, you're just going to see bits of it, just wispy bits of it on the ends. As you can see, I've made a total mess because there's all these bits that I've broken off at times and just put back in the bag, which I should have. Okay. I guess that's the problem with dried out stuff too. You will get excess bits, but it looks good. Sorry guys, I'm just going to get it off my desk. Alright, now I'm going to plonk that in the middle. For my glue work and glue it all up. And the paper I've used is a Tim Holtz paper. I think it was called Collage. It's an older line. I got it in a 2-pack with season paper. You know, the one with every season. But I don't know what that's called either. Got it from Mel from Scrapbook and Craft. And I'm going to use chipboard. That chipboard. I might change the way of my flowers because I'm going to hide that and I don't really want to. So I'm just going to put some glue again. And later on I can cut off any extras that are poking out that doesn't make it look good. I'm just going to put it in spots that I can't see the glue, hopefully. Hopefully you can see that. Okay, and I'm going to put it down the bottom too. And I was going to put things in the windows of the viewfinder, but I changed my mind. I don't want it too forward because I know my flowers take up a lot of space. Okay. And let's start. Okay, I'm going to go with my biggest flowers, like I always do. Okay. And these are all different colours, and I've shown the numbers earlier. So hopefully you guys saw that video, at that part. And I just want it in the middle there. You can see it's kind of coming out the edges. That's some more in that spot there. Rolling into a ball. It's a good way to get it to cluster together. I'm gonna put it that way. I think that's it. actually. I've done it wrong.
Of course I have.
That is meant to be in the middle. That is meant to be there. And that is meant to be underneath. And that is meant to be there. That's it. Okay, now. Just gotta figure out where I'm gonna add my next flowers. Start to add leaves. Just cutting off the ends that I don't need. Using Tim Holtz scissors, these are good scissors. Okay. Let's get ready. For the last bit of it. I'm going to pull that chipboard out a bit higher. And this side too. Because I want to see them, you know, poking out the tops. Let's just kind of push that over. Gonna tear that apart. So you've kind of got it hiding spots. Good. That's what we want. Okay. Now I'm gonna go in with these flat daisies that I've bent in half. I might add one there. And another. My leaves. Actually, no, I'm not going to add my leaves. I'm going to add this to balance out the bottom part. And now add my leaves. Again, it's about playing and manipulating the flowers. And again, I'm going to add this one on this side. I might not even use my cheesecloth at this rate. I think that Spanish moss does the look of the cheesecloth. Okay, now I'm going to add in my stems, which I'll put behind, and my bud. Stems I'm going to put here. That one isn't coming out far enough. That needs to come in a bit. Okay. No, don't like that there. happy with it. Might hang it over the edge a bit. Okay. Hopefully you guys can see that. Some cogs and try adding them in some spots. I'm just going to move that flower to there, that flower to there, and puff out those flowers, and that one there. Good. Needs to go a bit higher. That's it. And I can now add my sentiment later, whenever I want to, but hopefully you guys get a good look at that. Just move those bits over. So I could then go in and add like a cog if I really wanted to in the middle, you know. But I don't think it needs it somehow. I think it just overpowers it. Yeah, no, I think that's it. Hopefully you guys like that. And then I can just go in now and just add some bits in spots. The overgrowth has sort of disappeared for some reason or another. And I'm just going to add a bit there. I just love these flowers and just the look they give, you know. And this Spanish moss, oh, it just gives a great look of deserted and left to overgrow, doesn't it? I'm gonna put a bit there. Spot. I think needs it. There. Underneath it. Good. Let's just manipulate those bits. That needs to go underneath. And that's it. Last time. Hopefully you guys like it. Let me know what you think and I'll talk to you later. Hey guys, it's Just Cuts by Sarah for Wild Orchid. Today I wanted to share my finished project. As you have seen this go from start to finish, but I just wanted to show it finished. I had added the burlap and inked it. Again, this is Tim Holtz paper that I went over with the mask and some Tim Holtz ink. I've done some holes and my... what's it called? The wall mesh stuff. I can't remember. Gone blank. Memory box butterfly. And then I put some cogs that were from my dad's shed that I cleaned out. And I've got some rose leaves in the 40mm, the hip rose in the ivory and white. And that's the set they came in, but I've used the ivory. And I've gone over Tim Holtz ink, and everything I've gone over the ink art also, and Tim Holtz. We've got the stems. Down here I've used the walnut open rose in the 20mm, the cottage rose in the sage, it's like a sage colour off the top of my head, I can't remember. Again, all the links and the codes will be below. I've used up here trellis rose, and that is in the brown mixed set. And also I've used a gardenia, which is in the small gardenia miniature set, and it's mixed coloured. Up here I've used some hydro blooms, which were white, that I've sprayed and gone over with ink and ink gold. Up here was the another wild rose from the smaller brown set that I have. It is actually, the colour was two-tone brown. And I've used a white Cosmo Daisy that I've sprayed. And then up here and down the bottom, I've actually used that gorgeous chipboard piece that was from Wild Orchid. And it's the Cog set. And again, I've used that hip rosebud up here. And then, as you can see, right around, there is this gorgeous Spanish moss and the die piece I cut from my die mustache. That's pretty much it. Let me know what you guys think, and check out Start to Finish, which will be before. And let me know what you guys think, and I'll see you all later.